guys, welcome back to Halftime. Today we have an interview all the way from Italy. I'm speaking with Emmanuel Gyasi from Spezia, who are currently playing in their first ever season in Serie A. Emmanuel, thank you for joining us. How are you?
Thank you for having me in your program. I'm great, and you?
I'm great, and I'm excited to hear from you because obviously it's not very often that you get to talk to someone who's playing in Serie A for the very first time. What is it like as a player to be a part of this historic moment for your team?
Yeah, let's say last season was a great season for me and my teammates and for the club, because making this history for the club is an amazing feeling, because playing the Serie A for the first time is a great emotion.
And have you felt that the support and the respect from the fans is even stronger now that you're in Serie A?
Yeah. The feeling, the people are very exciting because of their first time seeing their team in the Serie A in the top level. I see people here very excited. Unfortunately, they can't come in the stadium to stay near us. But we feel that they are very happy to see us play in the highest level.
And now on the pitch, I mean, it's obviously been a transition period. How did the coach help you guys prepare to kind of face this new challenge and this new opportunity on a bigger stage?
Yeah, let's say the coach is very prepared, because even with new players coming, so the coach was very, very important for us, because with the new players and the old players, he tried and create a great connection that in the field we all play together, we train very hard, we listen to him a lot, and for now we are doing good, so we hope to continue like this.
And do you feel a difference? Is it more challenging facing some of these teams now that have such a huge history playing in Italian league football?
Yeah, let's say for us some players that is the first time, is a great feeling playing with teams that maybe you watch only on the TV, you know. So for now that you try and play with them every Sunday or Saturday, the games is a great challenge. It's very beautiful.
There's a picture on your Instagram. There's no caption or context, but you're standing next to Cristiano Ronaldo. Can you take us through the background story of that moment and that picture?
For me, he's an idol because he's the number one in football. So let's say when we play against Juventus, it was very exciting, because the first time you meet your idol and he come and shake the exchange words with you, shaking your hands. And I told him, for me, you're an inspiration for young players, for me and others. And he was very happy. He told me to continue pushing and fight for my dream. So I was very, very, very excited.
And during that match with Juventus, I mean, in the first half, you guys put up a strong fight. You just beat Benevento 3-0. What is the main goal that you want to accomplish with Spezia this season?
Yeah, let's say even with Juventus, we did very good. But unfortunately, Ronaldo entered in the second half and completed the win. But yeah, let's say the last game was very important for us to win the game with Benevento. Yeah, let's say this season we try to focus on every game and try to do another miracle to maintain the Serie A.
And this is obviously a huge opportunity for your career as well. You're being shown every weekend across the world. So what is your biggest personal goal to accomplish this season?
Yeah, let's say my personal goal is to make this club remain in the Serie A. That's my biggest goal, because for me, if we remain in Serie A, it will be like winning the league.
And I noticed that Spezia now has English language Twitter, English language social media. Have you noticed more of international fans supporting you?
Yeah. Sometimes I'm very, it's strange, because people maybe from other countries write you on Instagram saying they support the team or they support you. It's strange to hear that, because maybe not everybody know about the team, you know. Maybe they watch Serie A, but maybe countries in you don't expect, they write you and they say, I support you, I watch your games. It's very exciting to hear this.
And speaking of surprising fans, I mean, there's such a huge Serie A following here in Canada. So I would love it if you could send a message to your fans, to everyone who watches Serie A every weekend on TLN.
Yeah, okay. I'll tell my fans that are watching to follow us, to continue supporting us, giving us the courage, and we won't disappoint them.